In this week's video, we're looking at how you can maintain a healthy immune system. We've had so many messages, so many comments to do a video on this topic in light of the whole COVID-19 situation. First of all, I am seeing so many advertisements right now on Instagram, on Facebook, all over the internet really, of companies trying to promote the sale of their supplements, claiming things that they boost your immune system and loads more. I just want to confirm to you that these supplements who are claiming to boost your immune system are warping the truth. There is no evidence supporting this, and there is also no evidence supporting the use of any supplement, such as vitamin C, zinc, or anything really, to protect you or prevent you from getting COVID-19. None whatsoever. And to be quite honest with you, I really think that these companies who are trying to make money out of the current situation, well, they should really be ashamed of themselves. Now let's get back to my usual chilled self. It just really upsets me to see these false claims out there, and I don't want you or anyone really to fall for these false claims and potentially harm yourself. So please remember that most people can get all of the vitamins and minerals that they require through a healthy, balanced diet. Vitamin D supplementation, however, is recommended in the UK during autumn and winter time, and this is recommended by the Department of Health. Also, there are a small number of individuals who will require supplementation, but their healthcare professional would have let them know to do this. Now that we're done with vitamins, I'm going to tell you everything you need to do to maintain a healthy immune system. So what are we waiting for? Let's begin. So tip number one, the easiest thing that you can do to help maintain a healthy immune system is getting enough sleep. Because when we don't get enough sleep, we produce less cytokines. And cytokines are a type of protein which target infection and inflammation, effectively creating an immune response. So if you're an adult, please aim for 7 to 8 hours consistently every single night. Now, if you're 16 or under, you will require more sleep, and I will break this down for you in the description below. Tip number two. You need to be doing regular moderate intensity exercise. So what does that mean? It means 150 minutes of moderate intensity exercise every single week. And I know it can be a bit tricky right now because gyms are closed, sports clubs are closed, and the guidance is for you to stay at home as much as you can to protect yourselves, to protect others, which is great, but it can make doing the exercise a bit more difficult. But please remember, this does not mean stop exercising, because there's loads of exercises that you can do at home, and these moderate intensity exercises are going to help maintain a healthy immune system. And if you're stuck for ideas, I did make a video a few weeks ago with a personal trainer friend of mine all about exercises that you can do at home to help you lose weight. It was from a study done in Oxford. So if you're free, if you've got time, check it out. I'll leave a link to it up here. Tip number three, eating a healthy, balanced diet. And I know as healthcare professionals, we talk about healthy, balanced diets all the time, but it's actually really important in helping you maintain a healthy immune system. And I know we all think we have a healthy, balanced diet, but just think to yourself, what are you eating? It might also be useful keeping a log and looking at what you're eating. So the main thing that you need to look out for is, are you eating lots of processed foods like biscuits, cakes, burgers, sausages, ready meals, all which are high in saturated fats, high in salt, high in sugars, all which we know are notoriously bad for you? Or are you eating lots of unprocessed foods like vegetables, fruits, whole grains, unprocessed fish? So the best way to kind of think of it is, are you eating more unprocessed food or processed food? The more unprocessed the food is that you're eating, the more healthy and balanced your diet is going to be. Tip number four, it's all about stress. And there's actually quite a lot of research out there that high levels of stress can actually dampen your immune system. So what you need to try and do is stress less. So I guess it's more important than ever right now to stay in touch with family, stay in touch with friends, either via telephone, via FaceTime, via email, whatever works for you. Obviously, you can't really see them physically face to face because of all the social distancing that's going on right now, but find a way to speak to people and talk about what's worrying you. Talk about what you've done in the day and talk about what you're gonna do. All of these are gonna help reduce your stress levels. And if you know someone who's on their own, contact them, see how they're doing, give them a ring, FaceTime them, whatever, whatever works for you. Tip number five, practicing good hygiene. This is our first line of defense to keep germs at bay. So it's super important that you follow good personal hygiene habits. So what can you do? Well, firstly, you need to wash your hands often with soap and water for a minimum of 20 seconds. Now, if you don't have soap and water available to you, you can use alcohol hand sanitizer instead. But please remember, a lot of the times I see people using alcohol hand sanitizer incorrectly. They squirt a load in their hand and they just go like this. They're not covering all the different areas that they should be doing. So there is a really useful link that I'm going to leave in the description below. It shows you exactly how to use hand sanitizer properly. There's also an NHS video which shows you how to wash your hands properly. I will leave them both in the description below for you, and I'd highly recommend everyone watches it. And also, please remember that if you do cut yourself, please wash the area straight away and cover it with a bandage. Now, if you do have a wound that's healing or any spots, please don't pick at the wound or pick any spots, because this is all going to allow germs to get in, which is our physical barrier. We've had a lot of questions, comments, and messages about this, so I hope that helps. And if you do have to cough or sneeze, please cover your mouth and nose immediately with either a flexed elbow or preferably a tissue. Once you're done with that tissue, please throw it in the bin straight away. Do not put it back in your pocket to use later. I have seen people do that. You know who you are. Tip number 6, it can be a bit of a difficult one, but if you do want to maintain a healthy immune system, the evidence is there that you need to quit smoking. That is if you do smoke, however. Also, if you drink alcohol, make sure you drink the recommended amount of alcohol. Do not exceed this, because if you do exceed it, it's going to hurt your immune system. Now, for all the 6 tips in this video, I will of course leave more information on them in the description below. I'll also leave some links to some really useful articles, and I'd highly recommend everyone checks them out. These really are unprecedented times right now, and I know that a lot of you will be social distancing, so I just want to say thank you for doing that. You're protecting yourselves, you're protecting others, and you're helping the health system, so thank you. But I also understand that social distancing can make your mood quite low. It can be quite boring. It can be quite frustrating. I understand all that. And in times like these, it can be very easy to fall into an unhealthy pattern of behavior, which can lower your mood and dampen your immune system. So it's really important that you stay both mentally and physically active. So please try your best to maintain a healthy lifestyle, as we've discussed in this video, including a balanced diet, plenty of fluids, sleep, exercise, and most importantly, social contact. If you live with someone in the same house, that's great. But also, people that you don't live with, or if you're on your own, please maintain social contact either via telephone, via email, via FaceTime, via letters, whatever works for you. I really hope you find the information in this video useful, and please remember, do not fall for these adverts that we're seeing on Instagram and all over the internet about supplements boosting your immune system and loads more. You now know the facts, and instead, try to make these simple lifestyle changes that we've discussed in this video to help maintain a healthy immune system. Always remember that you are awesome, and I will see you next week.
Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.